Hey guys, it's me Morpheus, it's Carlos, and today I got an unboxing, not really a review because I haven't used it, but you know, I kind of found a combo that I like, and I'll go over that in a second. But today is going to be on the, there it is, the CEO sleeve for the iPhone 3G. It's made by Marware. It's like $24.99. Yeah, there's no price on here, but I think it's $24.99 over at the Apple store. You can get it in white or in black. And here we go. We're about to do something on this, all right? Real quick, let me touch on this. I just replaced my my tripod. All right, this here is what I was using as a tripod, guys. I got a couple people wanting to know what it was that I was using, and I had to replace it, all right? So it's a Platinum Plus by Sunpac. It was just a cheapy weepy. Got it over at Best Buy. Came in this little pouch. Here it is. All right. That's it. That's pretty much it. The reason why I had to replace this one, let me go ahead and pop this up. Reason why I had to replace this one is this here, and I want to tell you guys to be careful when you buy these things. This was totally badass. I mean, you pull the legs out, quarter turn, it totally locks. And this here is where I was doing my, it's set for like 15 inches right now. This here is how I was doing my unboxings because I had some big packages. And then when I wanted to go down low and go ahead and do the, you know, the close-ups, I would just shoot down here, and it's about 6 inches. And this here's why I replaced it. This bottom part here got really loose. Tressa, not now, please, mama. This bottom part here got really loose. I'm using the a Canon camera. It's really light, point and shoot, you know what I mean? But this here stripped out from just tightening it up and loosening, tightening and loosening. When you put the camera on here to get to the memory card, you had to pull it out. So just from constant use, this barrel here is made out of like a steel, and this is plastic. So, I mean, it just wore out. When you loosen it, it still kind of swivels. You see it left, right, you know. But it just got really loose. When I put the camera on there, it would just drop by itself. And I replaced it with a 15-inch model. This one here is made by Targus, and it's got a total steel knuckle up here. So, you know, it's got the little pipe that you turn and go up and down with, left and right. It totally flops over on its side so I could do side shots. Let me see if I can just do that for you guys real quick. There you go. So you guys see it could totally go sideways on itself. Let me move that. But what I like about this one is that it's totally steel. So it's not going to wear. You know what I mean? This thing is built pretty solidly. So, you know, I just wanted to show you guys what I was using. This here is going to go in the trash. If one of you guys want it, you know, just let me know. Somebody let me. It'll work for somebody. You could prop it up, do something. It works on, you know, whatever. It's just sitting here. First person that PMs me, they want it, gets it. You know what I mean? You know what? Should I do a giveaway on this? You know what? I'll do a quick giveaway on this. I'll check tomorrow morning. Yeah, how do I do this? I don't know. I'll figure something out. This isn't part of that huge giveaway I'm getting ready to do, guys. But this here's, you know, I'll give this out to somebody. In fact, actually, the person who was PM'ing me today about what I use, I believe totally went out and bought one today. So, I mean, you don't want that. That's, it's okay for someone, I guess, first video reviews or something. But, all right, guys. So, what I got is that, there it is, the Marware sleeve. Totally got the cherry on there. I see we got some battle scars on there. The Marware sleeve. Here we go. I'm going to pop this open. And again, I have not used this guy, so, you know what I mean? I'll tell you in a second why I got all these out here. In Marware fashion, we totally get that free swivel clip, which I would totally get if I was you guys, because if I had this clip, I don't want it just rigid, mount it like this. I'd want it to swivel back and forth, you know what I mean? But, actually, there it is. That's the clip that you guys get. Standard Marware fashion, you know what I mean? There it is. It works pretty well. It's got an angle, so it fits on the belt really nice. It does latch on pretty good. To get the sucker on, it's just slide it up. There it is. It's locked in place. To get it off, you just stick your, you know, little key or something in there and pull it down, but there it is. All right, so this is the reason why I have, you know, here you go. You got a screen protector in here. I know you do. There it is. You got a screen protector. You see the little hole for the home button. Screen protector and a microfiber, and their microfiber, I believe, is really a microfiber. It's not like a piece of paper or, you know, a piece of silk. It is like a little piece of microfiber. The reason why I have all these cases out is because I know you guys are totally going to hit me. Well, can I use this with this? Can you use this with this? Real quick, this isn't even a quarter of my collection. This here is just, you know, the standards. If this one here, if the iClear by Griffin fits, or if, you know, the Agent totally fits and okay, you know the Flick is going to fit. If the in-case slider fits, then you know that the Agent, that, you know what I mean? So I didn't really pull out every case I own, guys. This here is just, I did add a couple more. This here is a case in itself. This here is the carbon fiber. And I totally added this just so you guys see, because this is big. If this fits inside of here, then we know we're in business with all these other ones. But, you know, I just want to give you guys a variety. Let me say, what, real quick, what I didn't like about this, why I never purchased one of these for myself, is there's no holes for the volume, for the, you know, for the speakers. I believe they want you to totally put this in. Here it is, guys, with the Rebel. Here it is. Totally fits good. You see, we're looking at it perfectly like that. We got nothing busting out the sides. Turn it like this, you do see it's a little bit sandwiched out here, but hey, you know what I mean? If you guys are going to keep rocking this with the Rebel, you're in business. This is pretty decent. It's not going to fall out, and that's pretty heavy with, you hear it? That sliding is right here. That's totally with a heavy Rebel on there, all right? So, I mean, we're totally nice and tight. I would personally put this with the screen in towards me. There we go. All right, so, I mean, there you go, guys. I mean, it does do what it says. It does stretch on the sides. It does fit nice and tight all the way around. You see it. Turn it like this. You can totally see what it is. Grab it by the sides. Pull it up. Go to town. It's not going to scratch your phone either, guys, because it's totally really soft felt in there, almost like a microfiber in there. So I'm totally okay in saying that that will not scratch your screen at all, okay? Again, if there is no holes down here for the volume. I totally, you know, looked at this real quick as I was putting it in, and I'll do it again. But if you look straight down in here, there's no light down here, so they didn't even make this part of the leather thinner. Okay, so you guys are saying, well, we'll put it with the ports up. Cool. All right, we'll put it with the ports up. There we go. Now we could totally hear this thing ring. But, you know what I mean? I'm a righty myself. Where's the volume so I can just kill the volume when it rings? It'll still ring, but bang, kill it so it doesn't make any noise. It's on the opposite side. I don't know. You know, that kind of does bug me a little bit. I always like to keep my phone down. You know what I mean? And if you guys don't care, then all right, cool. Rock this. You know what I mean? It's pretty decent. Right now, it's going to sit straight up and down because we don't have that swivel clip. So that's the way it's going to sit. I guess if it rings, you can grab it on the hip and, you know, hit the button over here just to kill the noise. But other than that, I really don't see anything that I don't like. I don't like that it puffs out a little bit on the sides. I mean, you know what I mean? It's totally okay like this. Hold on, let me rock that. Screen in, by the way. Screen in. I just feel like the contour design is meant for that on all cases. So there you go. You see it's a little bulbous on the sides. It's not that bad. You know, being that we do have a big Rebel in there. So, I mean, it's not that bad. It does fit pretty decent in there. It's not going to come out. The sides do stretch. It is soft. You see that? Let me see if I can get it on an angle. You guys see it? There it is. So it does give. It's a little bit spread apart over here, like my fingers. Starts tight down here and busts out up here. But, yeah, man. I mean, my combination is actually a Rebel with the clip for the Revo 2. The Revo clip. That's totally what I use. I love that combination. I totally use a Rebel with that. I go to town all day long. You guys may see it in the video I'm uploading right now with me and the girls. I rock that right in the front, sideways. You know, I love it. There's my new... You guys see that? It's totally stainless steel up there. I love that combination. One of you guys hit me up with, hey, why do you have so many cases? Why not, if you love a Rebel so much, why not use that? Well, that's why, guys. I'm still looking for that combination I like. I tell you what, that CDO combination is pretty decent. It doesn't have the flash that I like. Today I was out all day. People, oh my God, what kind of phone is that? Oh my God, what is that? Wow, look at that. I had a couple dudes hit me. Yo, man, don't you know that color is... a little bit on the, and you know what they said. I'm like, yeah, but you know what? It drew your attention from way over there to tell me that, right? How about your girl, the girl you're with? I bet you she's the one that pointed that out, right? Oh, okay. So, yeah, you know, guys, I don't care. Say what you guys want. I love that color. I really do. It draws attention. It demands attention, especially when a guy pulls this out. I like it. Whatever. All right, so you guys saw what it kind of looks like with the, let me go ahead and kill this. You guys saw what it looks like with the Rebel. Let me go ahead and take my smallest case right now. You guys see I'm totally just sticking my nail in there. And I go up and out. I know a lot of you guys are talking about it's crushing. You guys see, mines aren't crushed. And this isn't the first time I use this case. I use this case a lot. It's not crushed. All right. Just be careful when you guys pop this in and out. Get your nail under there and lift it up and over. You know what I mean? Pop that out. Cool. And I'll show you this. It's not crushed. Pull that out. Yeah, this is not the first time I use this case. All right. We're going to pop that spine out. There we go. There we go. You guys see it. Couple marks, but I mean, it's not smushed like I've seen some of you guys. As you guys are, wow, look at that. And you guys are asking about watermarks. No, you don't see any watermarks on the colors. That's why I totally went with the colors. You know, from day one when I first saw the Rebels, I'm like, nah, I don't want nothing clear, because I kind of predicted to myself that there was going to be an issue. Here's another one you guys are talking about. This lip. You know, right now I don't have the spine on to hold it, but I mean, you guys are complaining about that lip. I think what's happening with that lip, with the clear and black, there may have been an issue. But with the colors themselves, I don't see an issue at all. And you guys can touch on that in this comment box if you like. I don't see an issue. I don't know if it's the pigment they used to color it that stiffened it up a little bit. I don't know. I don't have an issue, guys. You know what I mean? Here's what it looks like with just naked iPhone. And that works and looks really nice. We got, it's parallel on both sides here. It doesn't look like it's bulging at the sides. I mean, that does work really well. Pull it out. Man, that feels a little bit weird in my hand just because it's naked. But all right, you know, it's on your hip. Grab your phone. Pop it out. And again, I guess they want you to put it in. Home button down. You know, grab it at the hip. Pull it out. And there you go. There's your phone. Take it. Put it back in. You're done. And that works really nice. Will it slide out? Yeah, you see it? It will slide out. You guys see that? But, I mean, you guys aren't doing backflips out there. At least I hope you're not. So, yeah, the case does work really well. What I don't like, though, is, again, check it out. There's no port for that volume. And, I don't know, something about a loudspeaker bouncing off and ringing into itself that I personally don't like. You know what I mean? I guess we can do it like this. Volume up, cool. But now you're not plugging in any headsets in here. And if you're an executive out there, maybe you're not plugging in headsets, you know. So, you know, take it for what it's worth. Let's go ahead and take this and we'll put this into, the CDO. Let's do it inside the CDO. This is not the CDO, but this totally reminds me of that CDO, guys. And you guys see, I haven't done my install yet on my screen protector. I've totally lived with that for a couple days just because I've been busy. All right, so here it is with the CDO. Bang, we're in. So here it is with that CDO case. Man, I really like this. And it's not CDO, you guys see it. I'm not trying to say it is. It's a Inspiratech. I think you can get these on Amazon. Somebody said for like 14, 15 bucks. You know, grab a couple in different colors, guys. It's pretty decent. It's not that CDO, though. I'll tell you right now, that CDO feels a little... Anyway, so there we go. That's what it's like. And it was a little bit harder to get in there just because it is that rubbery texture. All right, you guys see it. It totally form fits the phone. It's not coming out. Again, that noise that you hear is that clip right there, all right? So, let's see. We need the phone. Pop it out. And it, yeah, that, oh, look at that. I even pulled the thing right off of the phone just because of that rubbery texture. So, if you're rocking a case with a rubbery texture, I'd be careful. Good thing I got my Revo up there. I'm totally going to try that in here. All right, let's try to do this face in with that open port down. There we go. It is a little bit firmer to get down. I don't like that at all, guys. I wouldn't use that case in here just because it's rubbery. You know what I mean? That texture. Grab the phone, pull it out, and yeah, it's a little bit harder. It works, but nah, not for me. I'm too particular to try and rock that one there. All right, so that's a big no-go. Anything with a rubber texture I think is going to be an issue just because it is a firm fit in there. Here it is with the slider. This should totally be ace. This combination here should totally be ace. And again, I do rub my the cases before I put them away, so I know these are all clean, even though I didn't wipe them right now. Trust me. All right, so here we go. We'll totally take that slider. Bang. Now, this one here shouldn't be an issue with opening. That one had a clasp when it opened. This one here, because it's smooth, we'll see how this does. So here we go. Oh, that went in really nice, really smooth. Here we go. We'll grab it. Yeah, that's no problem at all, guys. I like that. You know, that case does feel good. And I know a lot of you guys were going to hit me up. Well, can you use it with this? Can you use it with this? Can you use it? Yeah, you could totally use this Marware sleeve with the in-case slider. So you guys have the best of two worlds. You got your case. Get that swivel clip, by the way, guys. This one here is just a rigid mount on the front. You know what I mean? Let's have this swivel. You know what I mean? So it goes with you. You guys know what I'm saying. But, all right, cool. With the swivel clip, you grab it. You know, kind of give it a turn, because I feel like it's easier to grab my phone off the belt clip like this than it is up and down. So, you know, grab it. There you go. Go to town. Now, me, I keep wanting to put it with the ports up because of that volume, guys. I mean, that bugs me. Here we go. So we'll take it and we'll do it the way they want it to. Go ahead and drop it in. There we go. It's in. Grab it. Pop it out. Use your phone. Lay it on the table. Scuff design is right there on the in-case slider. Drop it. Lay on the table design. There we go. We're happy. Once we're done using the phone, great. Take it. Drop it back in your malware and you're gone. That's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for that combination where I can have something that totally falls. You can put it on. It's protected if you drop it. It's got lay on the table. But I can go ahead and throw on my hip whenever I'm ready to rock. I don't like the folio and the fact that you got to keep unfolding it, sticking finger in through the bottom, pop it out, use it. Now it's naked because that one didn't fit as nice as this one here. You know, you got to put it back in. That's what I'm looking for, all right? So this one here totally rocks. I didn't even have to put the phone in here. The only reason I did is because this slider part would have popped out super easy if I didn't have a phone in there to hold it. And I don't want you guys to say something later about, oh, well, that's why that bottom kept coming out. You didn't have the phone in there. Yeah, well, I knew that. So there we go. Let's get this back in there. Here it is with the Wave. The Wave, I don't have to put a phone in there. It does have that textured design, so let's see how easy it goes in and out. All right, so here we go. Wave. And already it's an issue right before I even get it. That texture. Now, if you guys don't have an issue in the world with that, there you go. It totally works. You got a little bit of the green busting out. But I mean, hey, it's scuff protection. Yeah, you see, that's a little bit of a pain for me, guys. That rubber texture, it totally fits. But for me, that's a game over right there. I don't want to have to, you know, pull my phone out. It's going to slip out of my hand. Forget about that. Here it is. This here is the Griffin. And this here is that leather one. But that new form is the same case, guys. It really is. I've looked at that online so many times. I'm telling you, it's the same case except that this one's leather. The other one's got a rubbery, soft texture. So let's get this in here. Good. So there we go. Feels just like that slider, baby. Feels just like that slider. Maybe it looks a little bit more bulbous on the sides. Well, you know, because it is a little bit thicker, it's got that leather. Let's put it how they want us. Home button down. There we go. Guys, that totally works really well. You guys know that if this one fits, that one's gonna fit. If that one definitely fits, you know this one. I even brought this one. Check this out, guys. This was just for kicks. I brought the Showcase. The Showcase is a big case. It really is. All right, with or without the iPhone, it's the same size. I even brought this sucker out to see how that would fit in here. Now, you know the Showcase comes with its own holster. But I just wanted to show you guys, you know, you guys, if you guys have this, you guys will totally understand the size and how much this holds and what this is like. So let's go for it, guys. We go face in, drop it down. Totally works. There we go. It's a little bit more bulbous. You see it popping out the side here. Let's see if we can center that up. No, you can't center it. It's just that big. It's a little bit bulbous on the sides, down here too. Right here, you guys see that. But it totally works. I mean, you can get your, you know, a Showcase in there. So you guys know, it's not that bad getting out neither, you know, because it does have that slip slidey design. It's not rubbery or anything like, you know, the Wave or that, you know, InspireTech one. But there it is. It totally works. You could totally use that. Home button down. Good. We're in. Pull the phone out. Comes out. So yeah, even just for kicks, that side, that Showcase does work, guys. Here's the iPhone, and it's inside of the Alien Form leather case. Let's pop this out. Great. What else do I have here? Like, if it fits, this is definitely going to fit the iClear. Why play around? Which one did that go into? All right, let's see. Here's the Agent. If the Agent fits, we know the iClear is going to fit because the iClear is just a little bit thinner than the Agent. So here we go. You guys got the Agent. You could totally use that for your scuff protection. Let's say you want to keep the phone on your side. You don't want to put it in your pocket and risk breaking it. Here we go with the form, with that dock part down. That totally fits. And that's a beautiful design. What kills me is that Marwar did not include just a little tiny opening. Maybe just a little cutout here. You know what I mean? That kills me. It is leather, guys. It smells good. It smells like leather. You know, it's a good design. Good. I haven't used this. It came apart. No big deal. I haven't used this in forever. So, again, I don't know how long this elasticity here is going to last. I mean, work with me here, guys. You know what I mean? I'm just letting you know it does work. Then again, you're not popping 15, 16 different cases in here every day like I would. I keep popping cases in and out just because I keep doing these reviews. You know what I mean? I have my phone in and out 20, 30 times more than you guys do. And you guys keep asking me, are there any scratches? The only scratches I have on my bezel, again, I'm really careful and I hate that. There we go. Maybe you can see them like that. I'm eye day ready here, guys. The only scratches I have on my bezel are right here. And if you can see those, you know you can see all the other ones. Let me see. Right over, there they go. You guys see them? I got little scuff marks down here. Right there. But that's from just being, you know, careless, I guess. When I take my dock, I just take it for granted, pop. Usually have a case on and there's an opening there, so I just take it, put it in, and I'm good. But you guys see them. Hold on. Where are they at? There they go. Right about there. You guys see them. But if I go this way, yeah. Guys, that's iDay ready. Seriously, I take care of this phone. There's no scuffs or scratches on the back at all, guys. I don't know what you guys are talking about. Don't use the slider. You guys are going to get a scratch on the back. Really? Really? Don't use this. I used this one for a week straight. Not this one. This was given to me by Dower Hippo. But the one I bought before I gave it away, I totally used that for about a week, guys. And there's no scratches on it. Trust me. I'd be upset. There's no scratches on here, guys. When people started complaining about that eggshell, that cracking, I do have a little something. There it is. You can see it. Totally make it out on camera. See that? Right there's my SIM card button. Right above that, there's a little discoloring. You see that? It's just off right there. It looks like there's a flaw, but when I touch it with my nail, that's totally smooth. It doesn't feel like a chip, like a piece missing. So I don't know if that's just a discoloration in the coloring of that white, if the pigment settled a little bit different there, but yeah, I got that, and I got that. That's it. I wish I had that zoom feature, guys. I don't have that on this camera. This is a point and shoot, but you know, it's pretty decent quality. Sorry, back to what I was saying. I actually got this one, what was it, yesterday? And you guys were telling me about it, it's ripping up here. I can totally see why. The rubber in this, which is the Revo, feels different than the rubber in this in case. It just does. It's a little bit firmer here. So I can see why this one here from constantly going in and out, you know, is okay. But this one here from constantly grabbing it to put it on and off would totally rip one of these corners. It's just dry. It feels a little tighter. You know that test I do where I pull it? Check it out. That's my lint catcher. My lint catching. If it gives really good, you know it's a lint catcher. It's a really good lint catcher. So here we go. We grab this corner. You guys see it stretches really good. That's a lint catcher and a half. But this one here, it totally doesn't give. But it's still gummy. It's still, I can see it. Why? So my battery's dying on here, guys. Let me go ahead and put this phone in here. So there we go. Now we're inside of the in-case protective case here by in-case. This isn't a review on here. I'll get back to that some other time. I just want to give you, yeah, and you see that does grip and grab on the way in. That does. So I don't see me ever using a rubber case in here. But yeah, it works. It fits good. And if you guys don't mind struggling a little bit to get it out, then whatever. But I do mind that. Here's the way you guys would probably take that out. Righties would probably go here. And that's why it's ripping there, guys. My recommendation right off the bat before I do a review on here, switch up sides every now and then. Take it off from the bottom left. You know, maybe take it off from the bottom right. Every time you guys go to take it off, don't keep popping it off from that top left. I know that's probably what you guys are doing and you're just wearing it. All right, here it is in the Revo. Let's try it in this. This here is that rubbery design. Let's pop this over, massage into place. Good. Let's see how this works out, guys. That totally goes in. Let's put that dock cover in. That totally goes in. It's a little bit bulbous on the sides. You guys see that? Same over here, but it does go on the hip really well. All right, let's pull that out. And yeah, there we go again. Anything rubbery is going to stick to that inside lining, and I don't like that. But here's the Agent 18. totally works. Here's that totally worked. The showcase totally worked. As big as that is, that totally worked really well. The wave case worked good. Here's the carbon fibering. You guys know how big this is. There it is. So with the phone inside of this carbon fiber, which doesn't give, all right, that's a beast. But look, totally fits. A little bit sticking up top here, but hey, you get the best of both worlds. You got a case to protect your phone. Cool. Case to protect your phone. And you also have your holster. So I'll tell you what, all in all, I'll give this product, I hate rating, giving a 7 or an 8. I'll just tell you guys, the only reason I wouldn't buy it is that volume button thing down there. The volume speakers aren't there. If you guys are okay with that, with, you know, maybe muting your volume, or you kind of hear it a little bit because it's muffled in there, go for it. Buy it. It's a good deal. It's a really nice case. I like it. But if that bothers you as much as it bothers me, I'm staying away from this case. I just wouldn't buy it because of that feature, that there isn't a cutout here for the speakers. So, all right, guys, you guys know what I feel about this, all right? This here is the Marware CEO sleeve for the iPhone 3G. You can totally get this for $24.99 at the Apple Store. I have seen it in...